All right, guys, welcome back. We are in match one with Jun Lantern, and we did win the die roll, so we are going to play first. All right, pretty solid Lantern starter. We can keep this for sure. We got lands. We got stirrings we can fire off on turn two. Hopefully by then we'll have a good idea what the opponent's up to for our Pithing Needle. We're just going to lead on the Spire here and drop the Shredder. Next turn we'll get the Garden down and probably just fire off the stirrings with the Spire of Industry. I have to pay a little bit of life to do it, but I would rather do that and be able to play whatever we grab off of the stirrings rather than filter through the Garden and use all of our mana just on one card. We will blind mill on their end step. Give us a little bit more of a... Oh, hang on. Oh, well, that's a pretty quick match. The opponent said, if this is Lantern, I'm conceding. So I'm going to assume that we're going to see a quick match here. Yep, there it is. The opponent scooped it up. So let's see if we can find another match here. It's a shame. It seemed like a pretty solid hand for us. Alright, well, let's try this again. We did win the die roll again, so we will play first. Oh, man, I like it. I want to love it, but I don't. One lander, everything else in this hand is perfect. I just don't think we can deal with one. We're on the play, we have green source for stirrings. We will keep it. We'll fire off Inquisition, and then if we don't draw land for turn two, then we'll fire off stirrings and hopefully find one. A risky keep, very risky keep, but I think we'll just take the pending here. Protect ourselves. The spell pierce is going to be a little bit annoying because they'll probably just pierce our stirrings. So maybe we'll get lucky and top deck a land. Nope, just Inquisition. So, the question is, do they... They probably just Spell Pierce the Inquisition. Let's... I think we have to fire off... No, I think we will just Inquisition anyway. That's going to set us back a little bit, but either way, the Spell Pierce is going to get out of their hand. They're fetching, they're going to Spell Pierce it. That's fine. That's why we didn't fire off the stirrings. Alright, so let's see. Spell Pierce gone. Battle. Okay. No, we will need to fire off stirrings here in order to get something going on. Yeah, let's fire off stirrings here. Oh man, there's a bridge there too. We're just gonna take Blooming Marsh here. Yeah, we'll Thoughtseize. See what they got. See what else they're working with. We knew they drew the battle. What else have they drawn? Let's take that creativity. No creativity for you. What is this thing flipping to? Okay, so it's just... It's more, fodder for them. another medal. Alright, Mike isn't gone, so we're getting ahead on our lands now. Let's fire off a lantern. See if they want to do anything about that. Alright, change the equation. Cancel that. Run another lantern here. And I think we're just going to run out of pithing needle here. See if we can force them to crack their fetch. Yep, there's a fetch crack. And I think we're just gonna name Reflection Kiki Jiki. It is a creativity deck, so they're probably running Fable. Yeah, there's the Archon. Dwarven Mine. Sure, make a token. We are going to need to eventually find an ensnaring bridge here. We have the mana to cast it now, which is great. Wouldn't mind finding a mill rock either. They're up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 mana, so they're not super far off of casting the, casting the Archon either, but that choke is going to slow them down a little bit. Let's just go ahead and make each player discard. We have to lose our Assassin's Trophy, which is a little disappointing. Opponent pitches the Archon, so I'm thinking maybe they have a persistent hand. They don't have any. Oh, they have black mana off the treasure tokens, I guess. Gets in for one. What the hell? Oh, they bolted. Must have bolted the. Yeah, they bolted the Liliana. That's fine. All right. I guess I'll just run out of this choke. Another pithing needle. Not fantastic for us. We might crack a lantern. We'll probably crack a lantern on their end step, see if we can't find a bridge. We are empty-handed now. So I need to find a bridge and some mill rock. Oh, leyline binding. We might have to crack that. Make them shuffle. Shit. Are they coming at us, or are they going to try to flip these battles? They're trying to flip the battles. We're just gonna play the needle. Glimmer Voice. There's a fourth land. Not horrible. Protects. That will enable us to use the Mycus in the Garden to protect the Snaring Bridge. There's the fetch. Saves us the lantern. I think we are just gonna name the Reflection of Kiki Jiki just again. There's some argument for naming Vaseju there, which I probably could have done. But if they could get ley line binding off of one of these rhinos, to eliminate our reflection, to eliminate our pithy needle, I'd like to have it back up. And because my Kissing Garden does not synergize with pithy needle, I like having that back up there. They're gonna flip that and get their rhino. Yep, 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 yep. We'll crack a lantern on our end step, try to find a bridge. Or a mill rock, something. Something to keep us alive. Well, the thought season not what I wanted. Really don't want to do this, but I think we have to at least get rid of the thought seize. I don't like it. You know, they have a bolt on top, and now we're down 2 out of 4 lanterns. We go cycle back to Glimmer Void. Lovely. Alright, we're gonna take a lot of damage here. We're gonna take 8. We'll probably take less than that. We're gonna use 5 to. We'll probably take 3, and we're gonna use 5 to flip that other battle, get another rhino. He didn't have a card to discard to that. Okay. That makes sense. Apparently he likes his draw. Sorry about that. Like I said, my dog's kind of a dick. This is throwing a fit at something. No, they're just swinging at us. Okay, I'm not even worried about this battle. Makes sense. We're kind of on bridge or bust right now. Because they hit us for 8 and bolt us, and that's game. So, oh, I guess we can take the Inquisition. We can Inquisition the bolt, and we're still gonna lose. They're just gonna bolt us in response. Yep, alright, let's go to game 2. Alright, what are we bringing in here? Choke seems bad. That can come out. I can go down. I think maybe the ley lines. Let's bring in Torpor Orbs. Bring in Torpor Orbs. I'll bring in Witchbane Orb too. We can bring this stuff in. So we're going to bring in the 2 Torpor Orbs, turns off the end of the battlefield and the Archon. Bring in Witchbane Orb, prevents any Inquisition effects, bolts, and the Archons enter the battlefield plus when it swings ability. And Grafter's Cage to stop the Persist Plan if they're on. I don't know that they're on the Persist Plan because I didn't see any black. But we did lose game 1, so we're gonna bring this in just in case they are, so we don't get blown out. Haywire Might's gonna stay in because we did see the ley line binding. Let's see, we can go down, probably go down a Clothis here, go down a Liliana the Veil, and we're gonna go down Pyrite Spellbomb here. It's not the matchup for it. Alright, we will play first. Hopefully we start off a little bit better than last time. Oh god, if this had a colored mana source, it'd be fantastic. But no, we are not keeping that. Alright, we got Bridge, we got Torpor Orb, we got Stirrings. We will keep. What are we putting on the bottom here? I think we can get away with putting the Cliffs on the bottom here. Still gives us 3 mana. And I kind of wish we had a discard spell so we could take a look for discard, but I'll take Urza Saga. I like Urza Saga. It'll work out for us pretty good. So, after this deck, we're probably going to take a slight break from Lantern and go over into 8-Rack. buddy of mine is thinking about building 8-rack for his modern deck. So we're going to build it and kind of take a spin through it, see how it goes for him. Or see, so he can kind of see how it plays and if it's actually worth building in the current meta. Let's see if he wants to do anything about the Torpor Orb. No, he does not. Alright. Let's see what he does. If he's not presenting a clock, we might start making some tokens here with the Saga instead. Let's try to land this bridge right away. Little Bosley going and getting the Island Triome when there is a Besage you, so. Good to know about that. Okay, there's Ren and Six. Yep, gets his fetch back. Alright, well, let's see. Draw for turn. A Lantern. Okay, that's halfway tempting now to not make a construct, but we are going to. Let's just Mycosynth Gardens here. I really don't want to expose Glimmer Void to a Visage on Torpor Orb. We'll just pass the turn. We'll make a token on the end step. And we're just going to pass the end step. There's not a whole lot we can do right here, so. Alright, Fairy. That's fine, I guess. Alright, bounces on Urza Saga. What a dick. Okay. Well then. Play the Urza Saga. Play Lantern. Play Lantern. Alright, we got another bridge on top, so that's helpful. We do eventually want to have one of these Urza Sagas survive and go get Pithy Needle for the Teferi. I still think we hold on bridge because I want to be able to be hitting. Probably hit the Teferi. So we're just going to go ahead and drop a Saga. We'll pass the turn. See what the opponent wants to do. We should have made a token in response. That was my mistake for setting the auto yield. That wouldn't be as big of an issue because we could have killed the Teferi already. But we do have an Inquisition coming up, which is going to be helpful. His end step. His end step? No, still my end step. We're going to pop a Lantern. We don't want him having that. Leyline Binding. Even though we have two bridges, Leyline Binding is a bitch. Alright, he's gonna draw an Archon. Still a few turns away from casting that, so that's okay. We'll probably needle the Ren 6 and then kill the Teferi. Maybe needle Teferi and work on killing Ren 6. We don't want to turn off our own Ren 6 after all. Make a 3-3. What do you got, opponent? Alright, let's do this. And we will activate this again. Make another token. Let's go get Pithing Needle. Teferi. Time Raveler, Turn that off. Alright, makes these constructs a 5/5. Let's run this Glimmer Void here. Inquisition the opponent, see what he's working with. Veil of Summer. Okay, apparently he's got something in his hand he does not want to give up. Alright, let's start working on this running at 6 here. They do know about one incendiary bridge. They don't know about the. Oh, he's got Leyline Binding. Okay. Well, I mean, that's fine. I couldn't have taken the Leyline Binding with the Inquisition anyway, but. He really wants to ult that running at 6, apparently. That's fine, keeps that Leyline Binding away from our Pithing Needle. Which keeps his Teferi turned off. Now the bridges are mostly irrelevant at this point, because he's gonna be able to retrace the lightning bolts. We know about a spell pierce. Bolts the random 6. I think we're going to get Gaffdigger's Cage off of this saga. It'll turn off his retrace. What you got, opponent? Another Leyline Binding. Okay. Targeting. Pithing Needle. Okay. Then we'd have to kill this fairy. Good lord, okay. I've just got everything. These creativity decks really do just suck to play against when you're on Lantern. They got all the answers, and you did. I think the misconception here is when you're playing Lantern online, you're going to see a lot of creativity. You don't see it really that much in paper. So let's. Make a token. Yep. Go get a new Pithing Needle. For the Teferi. Unfortunately. Really wouldn't mind finding our own Rendered 6 to be able to go get Urza Saga back, go get Grafdigger's Cage. But it is what it is. I know he's drawing a Teferi. Draw another lantern is fine. Academy Ruins is not bad. It's not fantastic, but it's not bad. Can't really get Sagas back, unfortunately. Would you like to spell pierce our lantern, sir? Change the equation. Okay. That's fine. We will attack. He can either block it or not. It doesn't really matter to me. I'd really like to find Grafdigger's Cage here. He's going to let it go. I'm not sure why he thinks his dwarf is going to erase our construct. There's a creativity. Let's drop into Academy Ruins. We're gonna clone our lantern here. so we can keep an eye on things. Now we're going to Crack Lantern on the opponent. To get rid of that creativity, keep up Cabin Ruins on the end step. We can get the Lantern back. You know, I thought that the Gardens was going to be great for copying Bridge, but I swear I've copied Lantern far more times than I ever have in Staring Bridge. So we are getting to the point where the opponent's going to have to block. I'm assuming they have a land in hand, so... Well, they should have drawn that bolt if they could double bolt the construct, get off the field to save themselves a little bit, but... I was going to assume the opponent knows what they're doing. The Fable... Sure. Activate. Let me know you have the spell pierce. I'll pay the two. Do you have another counterspell opponent? Alright, this does make it a lethal construct. You're gonna have to block here, champ. There's the chomp. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So yeah, I guess he's gonna next turn he'll get an Archon. If I remember correctly, he does have an Archon in hand. Hard cast of an Archon. What is this? Sacrifice a creature, a plane walker, discards a card, and loses 3 life. Alright, let's just drop this. We will be able to just drop it in a Staring Bridge next turn, so we'll swing in with the construct, force him to block with the dwarf. Yep. And we'll be able to Inquisition first for any counter spells, so we should not have a problem getting Bridge down. Yep. All that fun stuff. Now there's a Leyline Binding on top we kind of want to get rid of. Oh, he's going to draw it, isn't he? Or does it already happen? Yeah, he drew it. Shit, I think we're screwed now. Unless... We'll see. He fires off now. Targeting the pithing needle. Yeah, not a whole lot we can do about that. That is just the creativity matchup. Kind of piss poor for our deck. But try again for round two. See you guys in just a moment.